A normal human set of DNA is made up of 46 chromosomes arranged in 23 pairs. When a person's body generates a normal body cell, hair, skin, white blood cell, etc., it copies its entire chromosome set, both chromosomes from each pair, into the new cell. However, when a person's body generates a sex cell, females produce eggs, males produce sperm, it copies only one chromosome or the other, not both, from each of its pairs. Because each sex cell receives a copy of only one chromosome from each of the original 23 pairs, every sperm or egg contains only 23 chromosomes, 23 half pairs, rather than the 46 contained in a normal body cell. At the creation of a sex cell, the determination of which chromosome will be copied from any particular pair is random, like flipping a coin for each pair to determine which of that pair's two chromosomes will be copied. This means that 2 to the 23rd power, or 8,388,608 different half-sets of DNA are possible from a person's full set. When a child is conceived, the mother's egg and the father's sperm each donates its 23 chromosomes, half of that parent's total set, toward the creation of the child. The child then has a full set of 46 chromosomes, 23 pairs, half donated by the mother and half by the father. Since the father's body could produce 2 to the 23rd possible different half sets of his DNA, and the mother's body could produce 2 to the 23rd possible different half sets of hers, there are 2 to the 23rd times 2 to the 23rd, or over 70 trillion different possibilities for the genetic makeup of a child of any one couple.